Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Sammy here with another video. And in today's video, I'm continuing our mini planning series, talking all about how to set up your planner for the upcoming year. Last week, we talked about how to utilize and set up your monthly spreads. And this week, we are jumping into how to utilize and set up your weekly spreads. I'm super excited for this week because I really feel like this week, we're gonna have a lot of fun talking about how to really get the bulk of our planning done in a, what I would consider productive and intentional way of doing things. And so I'm so excited for today. I am going to be flipping us around again so you can see some of my stuff that I've done. We're also gonna be talking about creating an ideal schedule, and we're gonna be doing that together today as well. So let's flip around and start chatting about weekly spreads. Alrighty, you guys. So when it comes to setting up my weekly spreads, first I like to refer to my monthly calendar and write down any appointments that I have or any meetings, commitments, plans, whatever I do. So I'll open this bad boy up and I will look at the upcoming week. I like to plan my weeks the weekend before. So I normally plan between Friday, Saturday, Sunday, if I have time. And what I do is I like to pre-plan everything on a notepad. That way it gives me kind of some freedom to brain dump and make sure that I'm getting everything written down. So that way when I plan it out, I am able to just focus on the actual plans instead of trying to flip back and forth on what needs to be written down in my schedule. This is also just something that I've picked up from filming Plan With Me's. It's a lot easier to do it this way than organically flipping back and forth and planning. It would just take so long to do. But I've really realized that this just helps me, even on those weeks that I don't film plan with me's, to get everything down on paper. And so this is an example of a week. This is the week of Thanksgiving, and how I wanted to use my planner, and how I wanted to track things, that sort of thing. This notepad is from Plan with Lakin, by the way, and I am planning on getting another one. I bought this last year around this time, and I'm almost done with it. I've used it like almost every week this year, and it's really, really helpful. And so, like I said, I think I'm going to purchase another one. We'll see. I have a couple other notepads like this that are not from Plan with Lakin, and so I might just use one of those, but we will see. But that is how I plan out the week, is refer to the monthly spread. I also like to refer to my daily, or excuse me, my ideal schedule. And what an ideal schedule is that it is a schedule that you create that helps you kind of like time block what's most important in your life. It's a great exercise to help you take note of what you prioritize on a daily basis. And so I thought it would be fun to create one together, because I need to make a new one anyways for the upcoming year. And so we're going to do that together now. So this is how you make one. Is I would recommend getting a calendar, like a weekly calendar like this. I like this one because I have the times down the side, so I can really see how much time I'm spending on those. And then I have my week out the way I like it, with that Monday start. And really, it's just important to break down your current schedule. I pick out different colors for each item, and I actually use the Moxie markers to help me with this, because a lot of these things that I'm scheduling out and prioritizing pertain to my goals. And so let's just go ahead and get started. So 6 a.m. I actually wake up at 5 a.m. but we're just gonna start at the top, and I am just gonna highlight all the way across. That works. And that's because I have my morning routine. This is where I wake up. My morning routine has really evolved over the years. And I'm going to talk more about this in a future video. But one thing that I have realized this year is that your morning routine does not need to be this super long, intensive ritual. I always see these videos on YouTube and Instagram of these people waking up so early and doing all of these things like journaling and reading and working out. And I just don't have the time for that. And I'm acknowledging that. I really have time to wake up, get myself ready, get my daughter ready, and get out the door so we can go to daycare and to work. And so that is my routine. That's why I'm giving myself an hour. Really, it takes an hour and a half to get ready, because I wake up at 5 and then I normally get done around 6:30, and that's when I'm leaving for work, which is the next item. So what I'm gonna do is I get done with work. We're just gonna say 3:30, because that's normally what time we'd be getting home. And so I'm going to block out this time, because ideally during this time of the year, I am at work from 7 to 3 every day, Monday through Friday. If you have a schedule like this where you're a teacher and your schedule changes, I recommend making an ideal schedule for the school year and then making one for the summertime, so that way you can utilize your time the best that you can during that time of your life. Okay, when I get home, I start right on dinner, just because my husband normally gets home around 4:35, and we're usually all hungry. We eat earlier in the day or in the evening, just because it just makes sense for us to. And so from 4 to 5, we are making and eating dinner. So I'm gonna block out this time. For dinner. And I'm using the health and wellness, because I would consider dinner to be part of my health, because I'm eating. And I'm just gonna write dinner. One thing I want to note too is, just because you're making an ideal schedule like this does not mean that your days are going to always go like this. Like on the weekends, sometimes we don't eat dinner until like 6 or 7. And that's how it is sometimes on weekdays too, depending on what we have after work. But the whole purpose behind this is to just help you see how you're spending your time and where your time is going on days where you don't have anything going on, if that makes sense. It's like a daily routine type of deal. And so after dinner, from 5 to 5:30, so just this first little slot, we do a cleanup. We clean up dinner and we do like a daily tidy type situation where we just pick up. So I'm just gonna write tidy. And once again, I'm doing it straight across, because I am trying, one of my goals for 2024 is to not perfect, but really get a good solid PM routine. Because I feel like if I have a good PM routine, my mornings will go a lot better. So after we do our daily tidy, we're going to want some family time. So we're going to spend that next half hour doing something as a family. And that could be playing a game, that could be watching something, that could just be playing or talking. Really, it depends on what my daughter is in the mood for. But I really want to make sure that we are spending time as a family. And once again, on the weekends where we see each other all day, family time actually might be moved up here, but I'm going to keep it scheduled for the evening. Just because who knows how our Saturday mornings or afternoons are going to be. Okay, and that's actually going to go for an hour. That's what I was scheduled for, not a half hour. So I'm going to go back in, and it's okay if you make mistakes. We all do. And I'm going to block out that time. And I actually might. Should I run the purple through it again? I think I'm going to. There we go. Family time for an hour. And then at 6:30, I'm wanting to work out. And this is gonna go for a half hour. Monday through Friday. And I'm gonna say Monday through Friday because, once again, our weekends normally are pretty busy. If I have time to work out on a Saturday, it will probably be more likely in the morning. So I am going to just say Monday through Friday with that. For right now, it could change. Okay, and then after working out, I am going to shower and get ready for bed, kind of start my PM routine. This is really all my PM routine, but I guess this is more of like my personal hygiene. I'm just gonna write shower. Shower, blow dry my hair, clean my face, all that fun stuff. And then it would be time to get my daughter to bed. And start her PM routine of getting her jammies on, reading books, singing songs, that sort of thing. Okay, once she is asleep, which varies on the night depending on when she is ready to go to bed, I want to spend some time with my husband, and we want to be better about reading our scriptures, and so I am going to put that down here at the 8:30 mark, just to give us like an hour to get her to bed. Like I said, I know this might differ depending on how she's feeling, but I want to make sure I fit everything on here. And this is like best case scenario. Okay, so we have scripture study, and then from like 9 o'clock basically, this is where I want to like wind down for the night, have some like me time, maybe read a little bit for myself, have some time with my husband. But I'm gonna put it in yellow for personal. And I'm just gonna write wind down. And my goal is to go to sleep by 10. Okay, also for spiritual, I do want to make sure I block out time for church. Okay, but here is an ideal schedule, how I would want to spend my time on a weekly basis. These two things are totally different. I refer to this when I'm doing this, but, and I use my monthly calendar, but in the end result, when I'm actually planning, like these are how my spreads turn out. I'm not writing all of this like nitty gritty stuff that I just did. I am focusing more on like to-dos and things like that that I need to get done throughout the day, or things I want to focus on that go along with this. Okay, and so that's the whole purpose behind this, is just kind of see like how I want to spend my time, what the reality of the week's going to be, and then planning it out really in my planner. And so that are just some tips that I want to give you guys when you're setting up a weekly spread. After referring to my monthly calendar and ideal schedule, I feel like I'm all ready to sit down and plan out my week, get it all set up with the stickers, and just have some fun with it. And like I said, we're all different. We all plan differently. This might not work for you, but I do recommend you trying it out and seeing if it does. I really feel like color coding it and helping see like where you're spending your time really does help with kind of like doing like a personal, I guess, audit on yourself and your time and planning. And so anyways, you guys, that is what I have for you today. When it comes to talking about weekly spreads, let me know if you have any other weekly planning tips. Share them down in the comments below, or if there's anything that stuck out to you in this video, let me know and you can comment that below too. Don't forget to like this video and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my planning content here on YouTube. And until next time, guys, I'll see you all later. Bye.